Hey, Thrive High Schoolers, hope you are doing well. I keep saying it every single time on these videos, but I really hope you're staying connected. We are still doing our Zoom hangout meetings on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I'm looking at possibly doing a new time for one of those coming up soon, maybe on an evening, so keep your ears and eyes open for that. You'll be hearing about that from me hopefully really soon. Also still sending out daily text messages with a Bible verse encouragement. If you're not getting those still, I would love to send those your way. Over these last couple of weeks, and really a couple months ago, I started reading this book from Pastor Craig Rochelle. It's called Dangerous Prayers. I only really read the introduction, and I want to dig into some of that. But even going back 2 weeks from maybe 3 weeks ago, the week before Easter, Pastor Nathan was talking about Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane and the struggle that Jesus went through there about going and saying yes to God's plan. And that got me thinking about something I read in this book and really wanted to share with you guys. And really, I want to launch into these next 4 weeks, including today and the 3 weeks after this, really working on what does my prayer life look like? What should it look like? How can I improve? How can I pray dangerous prayers, prayers that are not just the same old thing that I've been praying over and over again? Because I don't know about you, but for me, I can find myself falling into patterns where it's just like me and Sam pray with Judah every single night. It's something we've done since before he was born, the whole time she was pregnant. But we do it as a family and it's really good. But I can find myself falling into the same pattern of praying the same thing the same way. Or maybe you think about when you're praying for a meal, if you pray at meal times, you're just, Lord, bless this food to our bodies, the hands prepared it, and you're gonna pray, amen. And it can just become this thing that you're just saying and it doesn't have a lot of meaning to it. And in this book, Pastor Craig was saying how one of his friends was talking to him and basically telling him, like, your prayers are lame. And he was kind of taken aback by that. And he's like, I'm a pastor. What are you talking about? And he was just realizing that his friend was really right. And it really challenged him to grow in this area of his prayer life. And he was saying, giving some examples of people in the Bible that prayed big prayers, like David praying big prayers, Gideon praying huge prayers, the nation of Israel, some of the things that they prayed. And he says here in the introduction, and there I was praying that God would keep me safe and bless my burger and fries. That's kind of some lame praying, but I've been guilty of that. He says, my friend was right. My prayers were lame. Maybe you can relate. It's not that you don't believe in prayer. You do, but you're stuck in a rut. You pray about the same struggles and the same requests in the same way at the same time, if you even try to pray at all. Like me, you probably know you should pray more and with more passion, more faith. You want to talk to God and listen to him, to share an intimate conversation like you would with your spouse or best friend. You really want to, but aren't sure how. So your prayers remain safe, flat, dull, predictable, stale, and boring. And when I read that, I was like, wow, like that's a big call out, but I don't think he's wrong. I think that he was really challenging me in my own life that this is an area where I can grow, where I can improve, where I can go further in my prayer life. I want to read a couple, that section was a little longer, and this next section is a little longer, just because it's so good and so challenging, and I think it can be helpful for us. He keeps talking about that a little bit more in the introduction. And then he goes further into this idea of lukewarm prayers and praying safe prayers and why that shouldn't be like that in our lives. This is on page 17. He says, but safe, lukewarm prayers don't draw us closer to God or help us reveal his love to this world. Prayers are inherently dangerous. This idea about prayer dawned on me when reading about Jesus talking to his father in the Garden of Gethsemane, just a short time before he gave his life on the cross. Knowing that what was ahead, Jesus asked God if there was any other way. I can read that here from Luke chapter 22. This is verses 42. Jesus says, Father, if you are willing, please take this cup of suffering away from me. Yet I want your will, not mine. Knowing what was ahead, Jesus asked God if there was any other way. Then Jesus, not just a regular disciple or some other person of the Bible, but Jesus, the Son of God, prayed a vulnerable and dangerous prayer of submission. Yet I want your will to be done, not mine. And this key phrase is so good. Jesus never asks us to do something that he won't do himself. He calls us to a life of faith, not a life of comfort. How timely is that for us in the season that we're in right now? I want to read that again. Jesus never asks us to do something he won't do himself. He calls us to a life of faith, not a life of comfort. I want to finish this section. Instead of coming to him for a safer, easier, stress-free lifestyle, the Son of God challenges us to risk loving others more than ourselves. Instead of indulging our daily desires, he calls us to deny them for something eternal. Instead of living by what we want, he tells us to pick up our crosses daily and follow his example. In this book, we'll dig more deeply into these ideas through three powerful prayers drawn from Scripture. These three prayers may be short, they may be simple, they may be straightforward, but they are not safe. Over these next 3 weeks, I want to pray those three prayers with you and really learn how we can pray those prayers from our heart. And those three, two-word prayers each are, number one, search me, number two, break me, and number three, send me. Three really short, but really dangerous prayers for us to be praying. He concludes the introduction saying this: it's time to stop praying safe. It's time to start talking, really talking and listening to God. It's time for dangerous prayers. And so, like I said, over the next 3 weeks after today, I want to dig into each one of those prayers and see how we can be praying those, what that looks like in our daily life. But for today, my thought for you, my challenge, my encouragement, I know I say those things every week when we do this, but I really want to challenge you to grow, is how does your prayer life look? Is it looking stale? Is it looking kind of lame, like Pastor Craig was talking about in this book where he was kind of called out? Are you just praying for your burger and fries and praying the same, maybe the same routine? Maybe you're not praying at all. Maybe you're not approaching Jesus with anything. Maybe it's just not a part of your life at all. And I would challenge you to kind of take some inventory of your life and say, man, I need to start praying some dangerous prayers. I need to start praying some prayers that matter. And then the other part of that too is, as you begin to pray, even this week, having that heart of submission, a humble heart, a heart of humility, saying, Lord, I want your will, not my will. Even in the Lord's Prayer, Jesus, when he was teaching the disciples how to pray, he said, pray this way, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Jesus, Father God, let your kingdom come to earth. Let your will be done in my life. That's the way that Jesus taught us to pray. But are we actually praying that way? Am I actually praying that way? I challenge you to start praying even this week, maybe one dangerous prayer. Maybe it's not one of these three I mentioned here, but you know the areas in your life where you're struggling. You have questions, you have unanswered questions. I know that just this last week it came out that school's not going to be happening for the rest of this school year. And there's so much up in that. My heart is broken for our seniors. My heart is broken for all of you as high school students that can't be there learning, doing things normally. I don't understand. I don't have answers. But I can pray dangerous prayers and give that to Jesus. I can turn those burdens over to him. And I encourage you to do the same. I can't fix it. And maybe Jesus might not be able to change this exact situation that's happening right now with school or whatever it is in our lives, but that doesn't change who he is and the fact that he is our provider, that he cares for us, that he sees us exactly where we are, and he's gonna come alongside of us right at that point. So this week, today, right now, whenever, pray one dangerous prayer and begin to prepare your hearts, as we're gonna learn over these next 3 weeks after today, of how we can pray those other three dangerous prayers. Search me, break me, and send me. Let's pray together now. Father God, we are humbled again by the truth of your word. And I thank you for this challenge from Pastor Craig. Through a book, your truth comes shining through, yes, from the Bible, of course, but also through a challenge like this book of dangerous prayers. And I pray that as we dig deeper into this over these next 3 weeks, that you would transform the way we think about prayer, that you would transform the way I think about prayer, that you would help me to pray prayers that mean something, that are meaningful, that aren't just something I'm doing by rote repetition in my daily routine, but that I'm actually sharing my heart and my thoughts and my feelings with you and laying my burdens on your heart and praying from that place of let your will be done. Whatever that means in my life, let your will be done. Because when I can pray that way, I know that I'm fully surrendered to you, just like we talked about on Easter Sunday. So I pray that you would teach us, Lord, humble our hearts, get our pride out of the way, and teach us how we can pray in new ways. Lord, I pray for each student, each adult, whoever's watching this video. Lord, I pray that you would come alongside of them and you would encourage them today, right now, whenever they're watching this video, that you would remind them that you love them exactly where they are, no matter what their situation is. like we just mentioned a minute ago about school, but there's so many other things that are going on in our lives, physical struggles, emotional struggles, mental struggles, whatever it might be, Lord, I pray that you would meet them at their point of need, that you would bring peace and hope and healing and wholeness into their lives. Lord, we thank you for this time where we can connect even through technology. And Lord, we look forward to when we can be back together again. Jesus, we love you so much. We pray all this in your name. Amen. Man, I love you guys so much. Thanks for watching this video. And we'll see you next week when we start praying that first prayer of search me.